Dearly beloved, we are gathered in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join John and Gail in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the love of God. Into this holy estate, John and Gail come, now to be joined. Gail and John, you have been called to marriage with each other, and God has blessed you in this calling. And to everyone who is gathered here with them, we form a circle of joy and prayer in this wild and very wintry corner of creation. In this place, we are each and all invited to breathe, to be, and to become. Gail and John have invited us here to share this very special moment in their lives. And they have chosen us to help create part of their beloved community. We are here to bear witness to their covenant, which is made in the sight and the grace of God. I ask that you would gather now in a moment of prayer. Creator, Christ and Comforter, be with us. Bless this day. Bless this couple. Bless this gathering. And be with us every step of the way, wherever our paths may take us when we leave here today. Remind us to call upon you, as you first taught us to pray, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And at this point, you will want to hand your flag away. So Gail and John have chosen two scriptures, and they're each going to take a turn reading one of those passages. Gail will go first.
1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8, 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious, nor boastful, nor arrogant, or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It's not rejoiced in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. They have faith, hope, and love of God. These three are the greatest of Jesus' love.
Song of Solomon, chapter 8, verses 6 and 7. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown. If one offered for love all the wealth of one's house, it would be utterly scorned.
John, will you have Gail to be your wife, and will you love her, cherish her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say I do.
I do.
Gail, will you have John to be be your husband, and will you love him and cherish him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, in hardship and in need, as long as you both shall live. If you consent, please stay, I do. You guys want a whole thing. So, I got to sit with Gail and John, and although you all know them better than I do, I want to share just a couple of things that they said about each other, because we don't all sit down and take the time to express why we love each other. And so these are their words shared with you. They came to each other from different places. Gail had lived all over the world, and she brought her son back with her when her husband died. John was waiting for her. They both come past in history, but they found each other, and they made a home in New Hampshire. They have walked, waited, and worked faithfully and patiently through a long and sometimes arduous journey, as well as a healing, joyful, and a creative one, to come to this day. Gail says about John that he is kind and loving. He completes her. He's willing to help even if she doesn't want it. He watches out for her through everything. Day to day, she cherishes the little ways that John makes life easier for her. One simple example is when he would wake up really early to make her a good cup of coffee when she had a long commute to Massachusetts. And another example is how he holds her hand at night when she can't sleep. John loves about Gail that she is kind and wonderful, that everyone loves her, and many people think of her as their sister, or their sister ought to be. She's an amazing cook. She cares for their home, and she makes it wonderful in every single season. And she has a vision, not just for details, but because she sees the possibilities that complement John's thinking, and she can see their way forward in the big times, and the hard times, and the most wonderful times. He also says she's tidy, and she may achieve a standard of tidiness that he will never arrive at. He loves her to pieces, and he has loved her from the first day that he ever saw her. Along the way, they have shared many passions. They love to ski and be outside in the mountains, and they take their faith with them wherever they go. And they are touched by the world, and their world renews them, renews their faith, and they find God wherever they go. And that's part of what we're reminded of today, that their love is mature and seasoned, and it is sacred. They have seen each other already through the most heartbreaking and happy of times. Today they celebrate a journey that they have been on for a really long time. And they come to renew a covenant that they made long ago, here with us today. And most of all, they remind us that we are never alone in our love. That God is with us, as God has been with them. And they have chosen to renew this covenant, not just with us, but in the sight of God. And we thank them for sharing their love with us today. And this is where we're going to exchange vows. So first we're going to do the traditional questions, and then John and Gail have prepared messages for each other that neither have heard yet. So you guys get to hear it for the first time, too. So John, I'm going to ask you first, and you repeat after me. You actually want to call the whole thing. It's good. Yes. And look in each other's eyes, and John, just repeat after me. Gail.
Gail.
I take you to be my wife.
I take you to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till
And Gail will repeat after me. I have to be good, John. John, I take you to be my husband.
John, I take you to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and for poorer.
For richer and poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And I have another thing to share with you.
That's it, thank you.
Do you have any questions?
Yes. John, as we stand here together today, with our friends and our family, I know God is going to bless my God.
Let it fall. After all these years, following the first journey, I'm not sure where to leave. But God is free, so I want to have him. I feel that everybody's standing there with us, smiling and happy. I'm married. I think you've been my faithful partner.
You true love.
I promise to encourage you, inspire you, support you, and hope of you. Stand together with you to face the world. Laugh and cry with you. Experience unending adventures. I promise never to take you for granted. Never to fall asleep, baby. Never to grow too old to hold your hand. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. The little things are big things. You're everything that I want and need. I praise God for you and your love and constant friendship. I make my love of heaven sent and I promise to be here forever and always.
Gail, I'm a blessed and lucky guy. I met the girl of my dreams 24 years ago. Such sweetness, love, and loyalty I've been so lucky to see. That you are the woman for me, it wasn't hard to know. I'm truly blessed by God today that you are married. I've heard it said that our lives are like a mystery. Time is quickly running. All the wonderful times and memories so far are far too many to list. And of the many things I've learned from you, includes the importance of having fun. Today, while it's winter, where it's pretty cold, our long engagement has been worth the wait. You are the warmth of the sun, my angel, my love, with a heart of gold, and you've made my life so great. I'm thankful for family and friends as we move ahead through life. But most of all, I'm thankful for God that Gail is on my life. Thank you, Gail, for all your love, for all the experiences and fun we've had and will have together, and for always being so kind, loyal, for continuously bringing beauty, knowledge, and new experiences into my life in many ways. You make everything better. I love you.
So this is the time when we were going to exchange rings. And first I just want to say that rings are given in token and pledge of your constant faith and your abiding love in one another. Rings are an outward and visible sign of the inward and spiritual bond that already unites your hearts in love. I'm going to ask the community if you would help in the blessing of the rings by simply turning up your palms if you're able to do that. And you know that we have a lot of cool hands trying to help that do the things. And this is a prayer. Gracious God, bless these symbols of covenant promise, that they may remind Gail and John of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in their life together, they may know joy and peace in one another. Amen. I'm going to hand you the ring one more time, just to be quiet to God. And St. John, I'm going to give you Gail's ring. I'm going to put it on your finger, her finger, and repeat after me. Gail, with this ring, I love you. This is the time when we are going to do a blessing of the covenant, which we have created here today. Gail and John, gathered with you is the loving community that you have asked and have been able to make it here today. But we know that there are relationships and loves that cannot be here today. But they are here in amazing and special and spiritual ways. And those connections are already woven deeply into your story. And in times to come, you will encounter other people who will also become part of your narrative. Today, however, this is the beloved community that has become part of this part of your story. And their presence here is a sacred gift. I invite you to turn toward them and receive their blessing. As marriage is a giving and receiving that touches many lives. And this part is a promise that all of you will make to John and Gail together. So get ready. I ask you as members of their beloved community, their family and their friends, to uphold Gail and John. Will you pledge your support to this covenant that they are making today? If so, please say, as happily as you can and as loudly as you are able, we will.
We will.
All right, that was great. Now I'm going to slip this one. In our presence and before God, we affirm that a covenant has been made. Gail and John have committed their gifts, their love, and their lives to be shared together. And a new family has been created. I'm going to first offer a benediction and then pronounce them. That way, if they decide to run right out the door, they can't. Or maybe go, leave that or something. That's what could happen. This is the benediction that they chose. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back, especially now. May the sun shine warm upon your face, the rains fall soft upon your fields, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Gail and John, having witnessed your vows for marriage before God in this gathering, I announce with joy that you are from this time on husband and wife. May I present to you Mr. and Mrs. John and Gail, Prestidge. You may kiss each other.